Okay, here we are to do another example of Disco Vision. Well, I already put the disc in. It said Disco Vision on it, and it was blue in the middle. And this is it, a 1980s, not 80s, 1980 Disco Vision disc for the Blues Brothers. This might be the first one they ever made for it. Because the movie came out, usually it says the movie's in 1980. So, and everything else says 1980 on here, so I'm only thinking this movie would either way, it's 40 something years old. That's a really old LaserDisc. Now, this time I set it up correctly. So I have a DVD recorder hooked up that I use to back up my movies every time I watch it. It's going to be a bitch though to do all these discs. There's six discs in this set. Oh, not six. There's three of them and there's six sides. So that's going to be a real bitch. All right, so I'm going to go to watch TV mode. I don't know if you can see this. Maybe if you blow it up to full screen, you can. I sent my iPhone for repairs to get a new screen protector because it got all smashed. So for today, this is the only way we can record. If I turn it on the other camera, I can't see it. Okay, let's just show you this. So now we're at the mode, blue screen, doesn't mean anything. Some TVs, when you hook up a laser display, you don't even know if it's on one sometimes. Okay, so what I do ahead of time is I put the disc in, which I did. I push record. This isn't a normal one. I wish it was. You click record and you go down to destination and send it to something else like the DVD-RW. This is what I recommend to people. I wanted to tell you is that you can transfer hard drive recordings to a DVD. If you're watching a movie that's like extremely long, like if I also have Lawrence of Arabia that I just bought from the local time capsule. And I got to tell you, that has like 8 or 9 LaserDiscs in it. So I don't know how long each one's going to be. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to try a new method tonight and I'm going to record everything to the hard drive. So we're going to, see, that method doesn't work very well either. And you want to know why? That method doesn't work very well because I have to keep stopping either way. I'm just going to do it the regular way. Screw it. All right, so record, duration, switch to DVD, RW recording. And I usually click start right when I see something on the LaserDisc display that says the movie is playing. And it counts up. It's not a normal LaserDisc. All right. Here we go. So yes, there's a lot of specs in it, but until I see for sure if there's actually anything wrong with it, like I can watch it like this because it's an old movie and I have no choice. By the time I could take it back, I got it yesterday. Today's Saturday, then they're open on Sunday, so maybe I could. I don't know, I could try it, but I don't think I would want to do that. It'll usually clear up, but there are some specs on the screen, so that's probably LaserDisc rot. But hey, it's viewable. It's not as bad as 007 Goldfinger when I did it. All right, that's it. Bye-bye.